Hello, everyone, and welcome to this new episode of Scrutinized Tech. It's been a while since the New Year special now, and I think it's time to make another video because this is a new year, and my resolution is to make more tech-related videos. In this one, I'm reviewing the high-end version of the Aspire 9500. I already reviewed the low-end model, which was the 9504EWSMI, but this is the 9504WSMI. Don't even tell me what E means. I have no idea. Maybe it means economic. But I am finally reviewing the high-end model, which I've always wanted to review and have in my possession. I finally got the recovery discs for the Aspire 9500 about 4 or 5 months after I got the low-end model and reviewed it on YouTube. But 6 months later, I managed to get one of these high-end models on eBay. These are hyper rare, and I cannot believe I found one for sale at all. These are much more common in Europe. But anyways, I'm going to give you a detailed tour on this laptop after we get over the specifications. And alongside that, I also want to discuss a few things before we begin with even the specifications. The high-end model is a little different than the low-end model, as instead of a weird mirror at the bottom, it actually has media controls, which is kind of cool. They both have a 17-inch display, and you'll see the rest of the differences later in the video. Enjoy. Alright, now for the specifications. This thing has an Intel Pentium M760 clocked at 2 GHz with a 2 MB L2 cache. One cool thing about this thing is that it comes with a standard 2 GB of DDR2 SD RAM. It also has a pretty high-end slot-loading DVD drive, a DVD-RW plus RDL fixed. It has a 1440x900 WXGA Plus TFT panel, and the cool thing about it is that Acer calls it the crystal bright display, which means absolutely nothing to me because it's just marketing bullshit. It originally had, unfortunately, a spinning hard drive, but SSDs weren't a thing yet, and originally came with a 120 GB hard drive. It has an ATI Mobility Radeon X700, which is kind of cool. It has a digital/analog TV tuner, which is really cool, so you can plug in like anything, pretty much. You have 802.11b/g wireless, which is really cool. Intel Pro wireless, you know, that stuff. And yeah, that's about it. Before we begin, I want to announce some new changes to the channel. There are some new additions. I'm changing the Scrutinized Tech thumbnail, giving it a kind of like stupid-ass skeuomorphic thing. I might change it, but for this year, I'm going to keep it like this. But yeah, this is just all experimental shit. I don't know if this is going to stay like this, but I want to kind of change it up a bit because I'm getting low views and not enough exposure on these brilliant computers that I'm like putting my blood, sweat, and tears to like edit and do this shit with, so I kind of need an audience. But besides that, I think everything else is going to be pretty straightforward. I'm adding benchmarks and everything to my videos from now on. I'm going to add more details, higher resolution, and I got a new dedicated camera with a gimbal, which is good because now I can stabilize everything and all my videos will look very professional. So I am very excited to show you the first video with my new camera. First time, Scrutinized Tech has been in ProRes 4K 60 frames per second. Please enjoy the video, and we are about to begin with the main part that you've all been waiting for. Here we go.
Hello everyone, welcome to this new video of the new season of Scrutinized Tech. This is the beginning of the 2022 season, and I want to kick it off with a rather interesting thing. This thing right here is a very cool laptop. I am pleased to have it in my possession, and I will review it right now. This thing is the Acer Aspire 9500, although I already reviewed one of these before. Anyway, let me show you around the design, and then I'll get to the ports. Then, soon after, we'll get to the test, which may or may not include benchmarks, but I will try to do so. So, let me show you around the design first, and Starting it off, take a look at this side, focusing the camera. You can see here on this side you have two USB ports, you have an express card slot, and you have SPDIF out along with a headphone and microphone jack, so that's all cool. You have a slot loading DVD drive, which is great, also seen on the low end model, and that's it for that side. On the front, there is this mirror-like thing, which I find to be rather interesting and crazy and quirky. If I can get a better angle of it, that would be nice. You have various different cool little things here. For one being a Wi-Fi toggle switch. You can turn on or off your Wi-Fi as you so please, and your Bluetooth as well. You have the Acer arcade button, which allows you to activate Acer's arcade button. It also acts as a power button if you don't have the instant on arcade installed. You also have a stop button right here, along with a play slash pause button, forward and backwards, and the five-way D-pad. Now, what makes this thing five-way? Let me demonstrate. I'll also demonstrate in the operating system, but that's in a little later part of the video. If I push this thing upwards, you can see here that it goes up, and that is the up function. By pressing it down, you're going down, right, left, and if you push it in, you are making a selection. So that's kind of cool stuff. You have two speakers on the front. This is a 2.1 speaker setup, standard laptop stuff, but it's really nice. Taking a look at this side though, however, there are less ports, but you do have some very interesting stuff. You still have a PCMCIA card reader. You have this right here. These are your super combo card reader thing. It can read Memory Stick Pro, XD cards, SD card, and even multimedia cards, so that's pretty cool. You have an IR sensor, which is always nice to have. You have IEEE 1394 digital, the mini kind, two USB 2.0 ports. And now, let's take a look at the back. So, taking a look at this side, we have the power connector, VGA, S video out, parallel, I think I want to say DVI out. You have this jack, which is actually a video in connector. This accepts mainly composite video. S video in, which is really useful. You here have Ethernet and modem. Don't mind that, it actually got chipped off by accident, got stuck on my clothing, but it still works. You have USB 2.0 and a Kensington lock. Useful ports, and don't mind that, I need to lubricate the hinges, that's a side effect. Now let's get to more of the design, now that we have the ports out of the way. You can see right here it says Invalink Signal Up. Nothing special, that's Acer's corporate talk for just Wi-Fi. The antenna is actually somewhere around here. It connects via cable to the bottom to the actual network card via Mini PCI Express. Actually, looking at this, I'm not looking at the ports again, but see if I can zoom into this thing. You can see here there's a little bit of a bulge. This is actually different from the low-end Aspire 9500. This is actually a different screen assembly because it was made to fit a higher quality screen. So that's interesting. Another closer look at the front for those who want to. Let me actually zoom it in. Right there. You can see right here, this is how it looks like. It says open on the latch, by the way. That's the front. On the bottom, do not mind that, that is just a memo I wrote to make sure I wouldn't forget that I have to jump through all kinds of hoops to get this thing to power on. Anyway, flipping this around so that the text is facing the right way, you can see here the important documentation on the laptop. Let me see if I can get this angled correctly. I don't care about this. The product key won't actually do anything, but you have direct access to the PGA Pentium M CPU right in here. The GPU isn't as easy to access, it's somewhere in this vicinity, but it's not a big deal. Acer has put a special kind of thermal paste that lasts longer than standard market standard than the market standard traditional thermal paste. So this is a bit better. Although I already repasted the CPU and it still cools really substantially well. As for the other side of the laptop, its design continues. All across there, you can use this to open the laptop up. Its placement is rather strange, but they had to do this to make Acer's signature folio design. As you can see here, this is glossy. It does not match any of the laptop's other design elements. This is just strange. This is not a protective layer or anything. This is very strange. I've never seen this before. Now, because the hinge is slightly misplaced, it's kind of hard to release the latch. Alright, so here is the laptop right here with the screen assembly opened up. So let me cover some interesting details now that it's open. Looking down here, you have a sticker that says Intel Pentium M. Obviously, they just call it Centrino, Windows XP as it is pre-installed with ATI Mobility Radeon X700, 256 megabytes of VRAM, which is crazy. But it gets better than that. The keyboard is actually shared with the Acer Aspire 1700, 1710, and 1800. I'll show you something about that in a second. Taking a closer look, however, you can see here everything it came with. Let me actually read this to you in case you can't see it too well on your display. Aspire 9504 WSMI, Intel Pentium M processor 760, 2.0 GHz, 553 MHz FSB, 2 MB L2 cache, 17-inch WXGA, high brightness crystal bright LCD dual lamp, ATI Mobility Radeon X700 PCI Express with 256 MB of VRAM, 120 GB SATA hard drive, 5400 RPM, slot load DVD dual double layer, support DVD-R double layer, DVD-RW, 2 GB DDR2 supporting dual channel, 802.11bg wireless LAN, built-in analog TV tuner, HWMPEG-2. Okay, so there's that. Let me give you guys a closer look at this sticker. So, let me talk about some of the stuff that it's listed. I actually did one change. I replaced the 120GB hard drive with a much larger 200GB solid state drive. It is a SanDisk SSD, and I replaced it due to a few reasons, which I'm not going to get into detail. The trackpad is clear of wear. It feels a little bit different than my other Aspire 9500, but maybe because this is a different manufacturer of a trackpad, or this is a later model or an earlier model, there are different factors that can go into this. Even the D-pad feels different. The keyboard feels the same. It feels great. Feels like something I can type on for a while. It's a great overall looking thing, and I really think I'd be using this thing quite frequently for a variety of different purposes. Looking closer up, here is, we have different buttons. That's the power button, Acer's Empowering Technology Framework button. Next to that, a P, which I am not sure what it does. A button next to that, which opens your web browser, and another button which opens up your email, which you could program to access Gmail, Yahoo, or whatever you want, America Online, it all depends. And you have three indicator lights, which displays your hard drive access or other disk access, whether your alpha lock slash caps lock is on or off, or if your number lock is on or off. Above that, you have the Aspire logo right here, Aspire 9500, and the Acer logo right in the center. You can probably notice on this laptop's design a slight curve right here. This curve right here is present on a lot of Acer's other folio laptops, but this is definitely the crown jewel of Acer's 2004-2005 folio lineup. This is definitely what Acer was trying to push. Now, this is the overall design. I think it's very appealing. It looks cooler than Acer's other folio laptops. The other ones look bland, in my opinion. But I think that's mainly due to the accents given on this thing, the sort of glossier effect. Or maybe the mirror or something just adds to its more premium feel. There are different factors that can go into this that I'm not going to go in too much detail just yet. However, I will show you something interesting. I will do a quick little comparison before we begin with the main test. Okay, so here is a little comparison for you guys. On the right, we have my Acer Aspire 1800, which is my main retro gaming rig, which I use to play video games. On the left is today's review, which is the Aspire 9500 high-end model. Now, let me compare a few things. On the earlier model, which is the Aspire 1800, you have yourself a different sort of appearance. You have transparent looking light up toggle switches for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And while you have the same controls for your media stuff, instead of them being more stretched out like on the Aspire 9500, they are actually more closely together, leaving a little bit of a gap between the D-pad and the buttons, as you can see here. One thing that's different is that on the 1800, these buttons were actually shorter, narrower, while on the Aspire 9500, they are much wider. On the 1800, the five-way button feels frankly cheaper and a little bit more wobbly. On the Aspire 9500, they give it a nice silver finish with a little bit of a translucent sort of turquoise or teal effect to it. Not sure exactly how to describe it, but that's what I'm looking at it as. But it functions exactly the same as on the Aspire 1800. So if you're one of those very few people that owned an 1800 and one of the even fewer people who owned a 9500 and one of the super hyper rare people who owned an 1800 but upgraded to a 9500, you're probably so used to the 1800 that the upgrade wasn't that noticeable. But besides that, these are virtually identical. Although upon closer inspection, you'll realize they're not. For one thing, the 1800 is thicker, and that's because it accommodates more cooling for the beefy LGA Pentium 4. And that's really the main difference. Besides that, they're very similar. Now, the Aspire 1800 doesn't use the same screen assembly as the high-end 9500, but it does use the same screen assembly as the low-end 9500, which I have already reviewed. And upon taking a closer inspection, you can see that it does have the same controls as the Aspire 9500, but instead they are located in the center where the power button would be, even though it's not on the center on the Aspire 9500. You have the same controls up here. Instead, you have the power button located up on the right, which I think is a better position. It's slightly more ergonomic, so if you have your mouse on the side like I do, with the 1800, it's much easier to touch the power button than it is on here. It's just a little thing. I really don't care, but I think it's just very cool that you can do that on this. One thing that I noticed is that with this new screen assembly, they had to fit a new hinge system in. It's a little bit worse than on the low-end model and the 1800, which feels really firm and steady. So you can see that this one has a matte finish on the lid to match the rest of the laptop's plastic. While on the 9500, it does not. It does on the low-end model, but not on the high-end model. Another difference, if you notice, are the vents for the speakers. The speakers on the Aspire 9500 are slightly bigger. They are from a different manufacturer, after all. But if you look at the 1800, you can probably notice the section that actually acts as a vent. The rest is just for aesthetics. But you can see what I mean. They try to continue the design to make it look more flowy, while on the 9500, it kind of just cuts off. So the only part that's actually been designed is functional. So I guess that's good and bad. I prefer this design better on the 1800 because they kind of continued it on. It looks more like uniform or something. I can't really describe it. Both of these have other similar features too. If I open this one back up, you will see here that they both have microphones located on the palm rests. Albeit, the Acer Spire 9500 has a major upgrade. It has two microphones allowing for stereo audio, while on the Aspire 1800, you only have one microphone, which allows for mono audio. So that is kind of an upgrade that I have noticed. You can also, no you can't, tell, but if I actually zoom out a little, you can see that the trackpads are slightly different. The bezel on the trackpad isn't as curvy as it is on the 9500, but it does have the same design. This one is less curvy, it's slightly thicker, and has a completely different feel, although the exact same function. Not a big deal, but it's just little things like that that I just can't help but notice. Especially on the latch assembly. If you look here, there is a slight sort of like plastic thing hanging off there that is nice and all. On the 1800, it's not there. Everything that you get is functional. So on the 9500, they clearly made a slightly different mechanism for it. But that is nothing interesting or that different. So let me close the lids on both of these. So zooming out, they look kind of different. You can notice a slightly different tint and color. Barely noticeable, however. However, if I close the lid properly, which may be a bit difficult, you will see something even more interesting. Another comparison I'd like to make is not only the different tint of the color, but if you look closer, you can see that the screen assembly is slightly thicker, not to mention it has a slightly different curvature in the rear. So that is rather interesting. You can kind of notice that curvature on the hinge because the bottom piece is actually the same shape as on the 1800, so this is actually a very noticeable difference. As you can tell, it's more rounded on the Aspire 9500, but not on the low-end model, which is the EWSMI, which I have already reviewed. Another thing worth noticing here is the thickness of the both. You can tell the Aspire 9500 is much thinner by about a centimeter at most, but it is still a noticeable difference in thickness. Mostly to accommodate different cooling systems, clearly more innovative on the Aspire 9500, not that it is bad on the 1800. Very good cooling systems. Acer generally doesn't make bad cooling systems except on the Acer Ferrari 3000 or possibly the 15-inch models up until more recently, where they have managed to make even better cooling systems. But you can see on here that it's still relatively thick, but not so much as the 1800. So I guess that has some convenience on some levels, to be honest with you. By the way, the Acer Spire 9500 is on the top, if you haven't noticed already. Here's the back now, with the same comparison. You can even see a different sort of shape in the plastic. You can see that, after all, they aren't very similar. They are just made to look identical, but they're not. You can tell that it does have a major difference here in shape, mostly done for the sake of cooling and different components inside, different sort of things that affect it. So that's another thing I'd like to point out. Lastly, I'd like to compare the high-end Aspire 9500 to the low-end one, which is on the right. This is the Acer Aspire 9500 9504EWSMI. On the left is the 9504WSMI. You can notice some differences already, mostly in this vicinity down here. On the left, you have the media controls seen on the 1800. On the low-end model, the media controls have been removed, and you have a Celeron M processor with integrated graphics instead. So that is one big difference. Besides that, these are literally identical in every way. Although, if you notice closely on the stickers, they are slightly different. Apparently, this computer on the right was not sold with Windows XP Media Center Edition, while this one was. However, the recovery discs I have for the Aspire 9500 do not come with Windows XP Media Center Edition. They come instead with Windows XP Home Premium. Regardless, they both come with Home Edition, and the recovery discs give you access to some interesting stuff that I could not cover on my original review on the low-end model. Luckily, with this one, I will be able to make up for all that. Let me close the lids on both of these to see the final comparison. You can already notice that the hinge on this is much smoother. But notice anything different? Well, not only is this slightly more curvy, but actually, this is the exact lid from the Aspire 1800. As a matter of fact, it doesn't end there. It's matte, and it matches everything else about it. While if you look closely on the high-end Aspire 9500 on the left, you can notice it's more curvy and it's glossy for one thing, and it's thicker too, as you can tell. Look at that difference. Besides that, these are identical computers, although they have very different specs. The right has a Celeron M, while the left has a Pentium M. Oh, and this one doesn't have any like special capture card ports, while this one does. Let us begin with the test. Before I connect this computer to AC power, I want to mention something rather interesting. When I turn on the computer, pay attention, the lights come on. Here's a closer look for you. Another special feature about the media controls I'd like to mention. By pressing the arcade button, the computer turns on and it lights orange. Alright, so now let us finally turn on the computer normally. Alt F10. I don't know why I have to do that every time. Wow, that's pretty loud. So, this is a SATA SSD. This is one of the first computers to have a SATA hard drive, or a SATA connector, how about that? And it was very fast booting. A little lower the volume though, we don't need it that high. Alright, so here we are in the operating system. If you see flickering on the screen, it doesn't actually look like this in person. I think I have to show you the mandatory screensaver thing. Let us begin. You can see on the screensaver, that computer right there is the Acer Travelmate 3200. That is the Aspire 1800. I already showed you that computer. They made it look really glossy. I find it strange that they didn't make a new screensaver for the Aspire 9500, but that is quite fine. I appreciate it. And you can see that it's lighting up to match the wallpaper. And then it begins the whole thing again. So we're done with that. So that was rather interesting, don't you think? Well, let us begin with the next application, which is Acer Arcade, previously known as Acer Aspire Arcade. Let us initiate it. So we are now inside. It has a different UI than the typical Acer Arcade UI from previous. It's a bit different, but it navigates a lot different, as you will see in a second. Move up and down this way. Oh, I want to go back. Yep. Press the center button to go back. And you can keep going down. Oh, what the hell? It's a little bit clunky on this one. I don't know why. But yes, that's that. I will use this instead because this is kind of annoying me a little. But if I go to settings, I'm using the trackpad now, as you can tell. Different things here. Display settings, nothing important. Introduction. Page down. Page down, okay, we can't do that. Cinema. Page down. Oh! When you watch a movie, the following special controls are added. Yeah, just screenshot that. I'm not going to bother through all that. I don't know what the shutter speed on this thing is, but it's pretty good. Alright, let's go back. Album. Alright. And now finally, oh, there's more. Oh, there's more. I don't think I'm gonna bother with all that. But you can see there's definitely a lot. Oh, that just takes you back to that. Okay. If I go back, it takes you back to the main screen. You can see we have no music inside the computer. I'm gonna use the D-pad again, or at least try to use it. Oh, well, that was... Ugh. I think that's a little broken on this example. Huh. Well, that's interesting. Album. Well, that's kind of interesting, actually. TV. Loading TV. I bet you it's going to start making like a fuzzy sound. Or maybe not. How would this work with... Oh, yeah. Huh. Unlike the Shiba Cosmia player, it actually mutes the white noise, so that's cool. Oh, what? Oh, it's still playing. How do I... Oh, shit. My eyes. It's gonna give me epilepsy. Holy shit. Alright, I'm out of here. Huh. Oh, that was Acer Aspire Arcade. yeah, that was, not what I was expecting. Now, I could show you empowering technology, but I want to do a little bit of a party trick and press the button up here to access it. Huh? Oh, there it is. Haha, look at that. Powering technology. You can access different things here. So that's cool. And everything's called E. I think that's cringe. Okay, I don't have Service Pack 3 installed, so I can't browse the web, but I'm not planning on anyway. It's no need to show you the internet on this thing. Norton antivirus. No fucking way. Windows Media Player says Windows Media Player. No need to show you that. Let us visit some Acer things. Acer Arcade. Normal stuff. Acer System. User's Guide. This is actually just the Aspire 9500 User's Guide you can find on Acer's support website. Can we use the D-pad for scrolling? Yes, we can, although it just changes pages. Huh, not what I expected. But at least the D-pad works in this situation. It's kind of interesting. Maybe it works as page up, page down. Oh, it's in color. Okay. So we got some stuff here. Or is there anything about the laptop? Any like, there's a... Oh! Okay. This might be your chance to see the prototype Aspire 9500. Now, what the fuck do I mean? Well... If you look closely, you can see here that this is the prototype. It is identical. This is actually a later prototype. Unlike the final version, you can see that the email button isn't translucent like on the Aspire 1800. Well, it is translucent on the prototype like on the Aspire 1800 and on the prototype Aspire 9500. So that changed in the final unit where they just made it the same color as the other buttons. So there's that. Here's the front, a little bit different than the production model. And what I mean is just look at that. It's there's no mirror texture yet, but it is newer than the previous prototype, which featured the actual Acer Aspire logo and an unpainted thing here on the slot loading DVD drive. So that actually, this is a later prototype, definitely close to production. So you can see here a little bit different, yeah. Although the same ports. Wow, yeah, definitely a prototype. And it shows you the specifications of my unit here. I don't know if there's a separate one for the low-end model or not, but yeah, very cool stuff here. Although, look on this one, on this image, it's not the translucent thing. This must be like the final unit or something. That's kind of interesting. Wow, showing you like the generic Acer trackpad at the time. The real question is, how stupid do you have to be to not understand how this works? Okay, I don't think there's anything else of real interest here. Let me just scroll down regardless. No, nothing exciting that I know of. Alright, so there's that. Let's go back to the Acer thing. Oh, come on. Come on. Alright. There should be more stuff. Okay. Yeah, Acer Grid Vista. LGR did a more thorough thing. I'm not going to show you that. Empowering Technology, you already saw that. Launch Manager, we already know about that. Launch Manager is just the hot bar thing, or it's just like the shortcut keys. I already demonstrated that. Now let me go, let's go snooping around, shall we? Yeah, you can see here. It's an SSD. Yeah. Oh, wait. Yeah, I think I was right. It is a 200. Or was it 250 gigabytes? Whatever. It's still an upgrade from what it originally came with. Okay, so one more thing. Properties. Here it is. There's my name. There's that. There's this. Official shit. Home edition. See, I was right. Alright, so now we're at the benchmarks portion of the video, so enjoy. Thank you. So I believe we are finished. Yes, so here's everything. Let me focus the display again. These are the results I got here. I don't know if these are good or not. Yet, heck, I don't even know if I can see the results or anything. Okay, so there was that. Now let's move on to the next one. All right, so let's begin. No audio.
To get 1,000 miles from the Earth, a rocket would need this much power. It would take far more than a human lifetime.
But a space station might look something like this.
To get 1,000 miles from the Earth, a rocket would need this much power. 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 Would need this much power. It would take far more than a human lifetime.
But a space station might look something like this. To get 1,000 miles from the Earth, a rocket would need this much power. 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 This much power.
This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power.
Miles from the Earth,
A rocket would need this much power. It would take far more than a human lifetime.
But a space station might look something like this. To get 1,000 miles from the Earth, a rocket would need this much power. 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 This much power.
This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power. This much power.
Yeah.
Benchmarks here. These are results, so I'm going to close this screen. So I think we are done. Oh, I really hope I got the results. Right here, 6125. I don't know if that's good or not, but if you're watching this video, you probably know. So that's it for that. So that's it for the benchmarks and the main review of the laptop. So thank you guys for watching this video and just checking out this thing. Now, one more thing before I go. I will quickly show you the Acer Arcade Instant On, but it's I already showed you Acer Arcade, so I'll just show you booting into it, and then I'll just end it there. So yeah, that'll be it. All right, so here comes Acer Arcade Instant On. I press the arcade button. See what happens. Of course, I might have to press Alt F10. Yep, Alt F10. You know what? I think I get what's going on now. I think you have to load, I have to put in a disk in the drive, and it works like a DVD player without loading like an OS or an UI. Alright, never mind then. It's not what I expected. I thought maybe load the UI or something, but I guess not. Alright, well, this is actually it, so thank you guys for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.